I'm just going to be recording my screen, so shouldn't be a problem. So that's what we're going to try to do today. So first we're going to create a single property website, and Susie and Krista are my my guinea pigs for today. Can you guys all see the command screen I'm logged into?
Yes.
Okay. So this is Krista and Susie. And what we're going to do is first start with building our single property website. And I'll be honest with you, I know that I've been getting a lot of calls from agents that are concerned because improv is going away. And although I don't think that there was even, you know, 40 or 50% of people that were using improv, I think that those that 30 or 40% that were relying on it pretty heavily. And because that is going away, that's one of the reasons I wanted to have this class today and teach you how to use command for your single property websites that you were used to getting from improv. I actually think they look better, the ones from command, than the improv ones. And I quit using those from improv quite some time ago. The two things from improv that you're not going to be able to replace, at least that I'm aware of through your current tools, is the virtual tours that were branded and unbranded and the property video. I assume that most of you that get professional photography have that option of purchasing a video for your property. So you may not even need any other replacement other than that. just make sure that your photographer doesn't put it on his YouTube page or her YouTube page, but instead they give you the MP4 to actually put on your YouTube page. It's important because it's, what is it, girls? SEO, right? every time you load a video up into your YouTube channel, that is SEO.
And if they give you the, if your photographer gives you the link, is that your property to add to your YouTube channel?
That, yeah, I would, if I paid for it, I would insist on having it and putting it on my own YouTube channel and getting the SEO for it rather than my photographer. It's, I would, I'm sure that you guys have forms that the photographers have to sign that talk about property rights in your professional photography, right?
No.
I know there is. I know that there are forms in your FAQ site that talk about that. So if you don't, you might want to ask your MCA or your team leader about those forms. Okay. So I am going to get started on that note. And the first thing you're going to do is log into your command. And we're going to go down here to consumer. And this is where we build single property or single landing pages or also your agent site pages. You'll notice when I go to agent site pages, you can't actually edit them from here. You have to go into designs to edit those pages. So let's go back to our landing page here. And Chris has been really busy on her all her landing pages. So let's create a new one. And Krista, if you'd be so kind, we're going to hit create a new site. And we're going to create this as a standalone page and say create page. And if you would give me the address of your listing.
It's 4080 Marblehead Court in San Ramon.
What's the street again?
Marblehead.
Marblehead. Yeah. All one word?
Mm-hmm. All one word. Court.
Okay. So I always name this page first so I can identify it when I go back and it doesn't just say agent page 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So make sure you name it first. And the first thing I like to start with is the branded header. So you'll notice over here, you've got widgets. We're just going to apply all the widgets first, and then we're going to go back and configure the widgets. So the order that I like to do them in is the branded header, and then I like to get the listing in there next. So I'm going to pull the listing widget over, scroll all the way down, and then I like to put in the market snap, scroll all the way down, and then if I want to capture leads, which hopefully I do, I'm going to put in my lead capture form. If I've got a video of the property in my YouTube channel, I can put that on here too. So let's go add that just in case, just for fun. And notice I dropped it in between these. And you can see the video turns out to be really huge, but that's the way it is designed. So we'll use that. And if we're going to use this as a standalone page, you have to add, oh, there's Joe. You have to add your legal footer. If you're not going to promote this page, the URL, as an independent landing page, but you're just going to put it on your website, you don't need the legal footer. But just to be careful, I always do. I might want to also put my download my mobile app, and I can put that right in here if I want. And then I've got the lead capture, and now I'm going to put on the legal footer. And that's here. So now I've got all my widgets in place where I want them. Everybody with me? Yes, okay. So now we're going to go down here and say configure widgets. We're going to just start from the very top and say, what city is this in?
San Ramon.
We're going to say San Ramon single story home. Whatever you want to say. Notice that you've got 30 characters in here. So you have to be kind of careful about what you're actually putting in there. It doesn't go on forever. And you want to put something that's catchy. San Ramon single home isn't that catchy, but we'll use it for now. And then make sure everything else in here is correct. And hit save and apply. Oh, you have 53 characters in your name. So we're going to have to take a little bit of that out. Just for.
Yeah, take out color wings.
And there was some spaces at the end of the email address. Hit save and apply. And you can see where that title goes, and it's pretty much just all your information is in here. Next, we're gonna hit the back arrow key up here, and we're gonna go to the next one, the listing. And we know what the address is, it's 480 Marblehead Court. So we're gonna hit browse listings, 4080 Marblehead. You shouldn't have to put in more than the address, the street address, and it should come up. And there it is, and it's the Susie Lang, and you've got two of them in here. Interesting.
Oh yeah, make sure there was one that was as a duplex, so make sure it's just a single family one. It should just be one.
We're gonna hit select. And over here on the right, you're going to see that it's starting to populate your listing. So what comes up first are all the header images, and that's this hero image right here. So they're really tiny. They're really hard to see. So you kind of have to just click through them and decide which one is going to be your favorite one. It's not going to show up yet. until we go back in. So let's just
can you for some reason I don't think that's the one. If you could go back and just put change listening, pick the other one. I think that's right.
You think that's the right one?
Yes.
All right. So let's go ahead and put in one of our images here. You can also hit custom image and upload a new image if you don't have one in there. So we're going to hit save and apply now. And notice it populated with the image that I selected. It put in the address, the price, and the status. And it's brought in the square feet, bedrooms, bathrooms, your belt. By the way, that's too many toilets for me to clean. No, thank you. And it has the property description as it was entered into the MLS system. And then again, it starts with your hero image, and then it has the full gallery of images as well. Then it gets into the details and features, and then it supplies you with a map of the location of the home. And then we're going to get into the bottom of this in a little bit. But first thing I want to see is Royal Ridge Estates. That's important because that's the community. That's the community. We're going to ignore the fact that I just did that. I don't know why those go away. It put it at the top. Oh, well, we'll leave it for now. Huh?
It's done that to me before. I don't know why. Like I hit something and then it moved it along. I don't know why.
Yeah. When that happens, if you don't want it up there, in this case, I would probably just start over. But we, let's go ahead and see if we can pull it up again. I don't think it's gonna make any difference unless we replace the widget. So let's go back and put in the widget again.
How'd you take it out?
I just hit delete.
Okay.
It should let us delete this one. Okay, so let's go pull our configure widgets again, pull the listing one more time. You know, I'm glad these things happen so that you can see that it's, you know, that you can recover, even though you may have to start all over again. We're not that far down the road, so if you had to start over again, it's usually pretty quick. Once you get used to doing this, it's very fast.
Can you use the first picture as the center focal point?
Sure. I'm going to hit save and apply. And now we're going to hit the back arrow again and go to our next one, and that is the video. And do you have a video of this or not?
I just sent you in the chat, as private chat to you, I sent you the link.
Oh, okay, cool.
We'll see if that works. We haven't posted on YouTube because we just got our YouTube channel.
Oh, it may not work then. It may not be a valid URL.
Okay.
Yeah. So let me just go get any old video.
What do we need then for our video? How do we do that?
You need the MP4 and you just upload it. Let's see.
You don't have that, Krista?
I don't know what that is. Well, we have to ask Patsy how to access our channel and upload the things. So we'll have to get a next webinar or a private tutor.
I would be glad to do the next one on YouTube, just on YouTube alone, because there's so much to learn on YouTube.
That would be great. Because we tried to log into the new channel that you created and we had a little difficulty.
Okay. So now we're going to, we grab the share, the URL from the share for the YouTube. Let's get rid of this one.
So we're pulling the video.
Copying
YouTube, is that right?
Huh?
We're pulling this video from YouTube?
Yes, from your YouTube channel.
So we first have to put our video onto YouTube so then we can get it back out onto this. Is that right?
Yes. Exactly. So now I've added Joe's video on his listing, and here it is, so you can see what it looks like.
Nice.
And now we're going to go to our next widget, which is Barton Hills neighborhood. That's actually our market snap. And all we have to do is go up here and grab 94582, and it's Royal Ridge. So once you put in the zip code, all of the neighborhoods recognized by the command IDX should show up here.
It's Deer Ridge, Royal Ridge, you just passed it.
I'm sorry, Royal Ridge, right here. All right, So now we can hit save and apply. And you can see right here, in our market snap, is now added Deer Ridge, Royal Ridge neighborhood trends and statistics for the neighborhood. And then we're gonna hit save and apply and hit the back arrow button. And then our lead form, we don't have to do anything with our app, but we're gonna go to the lead form and you can say whatever you want in the header. I think schedule your private showing is a good one for this day and age. Or interested, let's talk, that's fine too. You don't have to change anything. And now we're gonna go back and the legal footer, there's nothing there to change. So that's why it's already green. So now we can say done and hit publish page. And so notice right here, it's got the date, today's date. That's actually Bill Clinton's birthday, August 19th.
Oh, so, I would not know that.
I have a family member with the same birthday. That's the only reason I know. So now you can see what your URL is for this, the 4080 Marblehead Court. And that's kind of a bunch of gobbledygook. So if you don't want to spend the money in buying, you can't put a custom URL on here anyway. So it doesn't do you any good to buy one from GoDaddy for this property. So we're going to just go click the three little arrow or dots and go to change URL. The only part we can change is this part right here. The rest of this is the identifier for you and your KWID. So, but we can change that last part. And we have to put dashes or underscores. And you can see I just use the name of it. Oops, I hit cancel. Patsy. Let's do that again.
What do you add to the end of it before the address?
There's nothing to add before the address.
Oh, just after those two, that hash, that underscore.
You have to put dashes or underscores and say create.
We have a individual website that, you know, people can go to. Can we use that in there too or not? It would redirect them, wouldn't it?
No, I don't know why you'd want to do that. So okay. You'll see. So now I'm going to copy this URL and we're going to view it live. Here's our San Ramon single story home. And it's probably two story. Marblehead Court.
I was just going to say it's two-story.
That's all right. We're going to delete this one anyway. And then we've got everything that we just did is here. And there's the wrong video. Hi, Joe. Mm-hmm. And there is Deer Ridge Court.
I'm on mute. Hi, Pats.
I stole one of your videos as demonstration purpose.
Can you hear me?
Uh-huh.
Oh, okay, good. Yeah, I've been watching.
Good. So here's your market snap for the neighborhood, your download the KW app, and your lead capture, and your eye catch it, and your footer. So it all looks good. Once you're happy with it, if you're not happy with it, you can't edit it from here, but it doesn't always work. So sometimes it's easier just to start over. But you can also just deactivate it and then create a new one. But you can also delete it. But right now we're going to pretend like it's all perfect and we're just going to copy our URL. And then Susie and Krista, I'm going to go into the back end of your website to your Wix dashboard here. Mm-hmm. Right here, and I'm going to edit your site.
So Patsy, all the prior landing pages that I've done for our listings, I can add, just copy the URL and add and do what you're doing to this one, right?
Correct. So here we're going to go to see our pages menu up here. So this lets us add a page, but we're not actually adding a page, we're adding an external URL. So we're gonna click on our menu up here and see where this, it says add item, and this is add a link. This is linked to an external website. So what we created is an independent standalone web page. So we're gonna click on this little link here and say we're going to add it to a web page, and we're going to paste that URL right here. And now we're going to call it 4080 Marblehead Court and say done. And now we are going to, let's pull it up here underneath. Underneath the search.
We have a featured homes.
It's an external link though. So I can't create, I can do a submenu of your featured homes. Okay, I didn't think I could do that with an external link. So now we're gonna hit, we're gonna close this and we're gonna hit save. And even though you save it, it doesn't make it live. So you always have to hit publish. And if you ever do that and you're going, oh, I didn't mean to publish that, you can always go back to your saved here and go to your view your site history and then restore your previous version. So you're not really breaking your website when you do things. If you screw it up, you can recover. So now we're gonna go over here to where it says publish, and we're gonna say view live site, view site. And we're gonna see our good work show up here.
I have a little thing I tried to do.
Under featured homes, we have 4080 Marblehead Court. That's the one we just added. And there is your website.
Awesome.
It's perfect, except for Joe on there.
I know. Thanks for Joe.
I'm everywhere.
Joe's everywhere. So that's how easy it is to add a single property website using command onto your Wix websites. For those
awesome.
of you that have placed your websites, if you go under to your menu under your site actions, and you add a custom URL, you can do the exact same thing. Just paste that URL right in there and then drag it up to wherever you want it. And on the menu and it will show up. So, and the other thing too is when you do this, you have to make sure that when the property sells, that you either change, you have to delete this. And to delete it, you're just going to remove it. You're just going to take it off your menu.
So remove it now. So show us how to do that.
How to take it off?
Mm-hmm.
All you do is go back to your, in your domain, I mean your Wix website dashboard, and go to edit. And then you're going to click on your menu. And you're going to go over here because now it's pending and sold. So you're going to click the three little buttons and say remove menu item. And it's gone.
Nice. And then save and publish.
And then save and publish. So the other thing that I wanted to cover today is how to use the dynamic property. Does anyone have any questions on the single property? How to do any of that? Speak up if you do.
Yeah, we don't have any questions until you're gone.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, so what I'm gonna do is I am going to take, let's see. Joe, do you want the properties on yours?
Sure.
All right, so I'm going to edit Joe now. So a dynamic page is like your blog post or your testimonials where the newest always populates in first. And then everything else just keeps rolling down the page and stays there forever until you get rid of it. For those of you that have testimonials on here, if you're adding testimonials and you notice you only have like 10 or 15 that are actually showing, you may have to go in and set your testimonial settings to show, you know, 50 on your page or something, because there it does have a limit, but it's only, you have to just change it. So if I go over here to menus, the site menu, and let's see, reviews, if I go to actions, and I say, here's his review all page, it's going to bring it up here. And then I click on the three little dots, and I go to settings, and I say add filters and sorting. See, he's only got 12 showing, so we can change this to 25. So his all will show that he puts on here. If you get more than 25, A, most people aren't going to read that many, but you can always go and change this to 40 or 50 or whatever you want. And if you change your sort, you got to make sure that you change it here too. Otherwise, try not to touch these. Your sort should all be set up just right. So that's what a dynamic page is. And like my event pages, those are also a type of dynamic page, but those have a trigger to where they disappear after the event. So then my event page is blank. So they don't stay on forever, where these stay on forever. So you're going to see in here, actually Wix has built us a really nice dynamic properties page. And it should be here. If it's not, you can go create a new collection and find it in the collection. But it's all built and it's all ready to go. So all you have to do is select it. So the properties. All of these are actually built. You can see this is what's just in here, 12 bedrooms and 12 bathrooms, right? That's way more toilets. This is all just placeholder stuff that you can see. And if you look at it, it's an Excel spreadsheet. It's columns and rows, right? So if we want to change something in here, like we don't need, you know, I doubt that I'm gonna need the year built. So I'm going to delete that column. I don't want the bathrooms clear down here. I want it up by the bedrooms. I can just drag it and drop it right here. The agent email, I'm not going to put anybody else's on here that other than mine. So I don't know that I need that there, but maybe I'll leave it and see where it falls first. The property type, I probably don't need that. This is the hero image right here. So we definitely want that. We definitely want the description. Square foot, I kind of like to do bedrooms, bathrooms, and square footage all together. So I'm gonna drag that over there. And price. So let's get the price over here too, because we kind of, that's kind of an important thing. Let's put it just before the map location, after the square footage. Okay, so there's price. You can also rename these and you can close these down. Again, I want you to see that it's just like an Excel spreadsheet. And the title is going to probably be the street address, unless you live in an area where they name everything Casa D something. And then you could actually put the name of the property. Agent, email, property description. Now, some of us may not want to be uploading, you know, a whole bunch of images. They show five. If you pick five of them to upload in here, I think that's really sufficient. But otherwise, if you're not going to put the gallery in here at all, just get rid of it. Just delete it. I think the status is good to have, and I'll tell you why. I like to actually put the status over here. So let's get it before. So if, as long as it's for sale, it's fine. But if I want to go in now and change property number one, sold, and maybe property number three is pending. I can change the status, and then as they're sold, I don't have to remove them from here. So I'm now consequently building my, my basically a spreadsheet of my sold properties that I have bragging rights on that will now remain on my site. So, but I, what I might do is I might go in and change this image to have it have a sold banner across it. So I might just swap out this one image saying sold or pending. But this way, you're not having to redo them and you're not creating a lot externally and having to import it. I do want you to notice that you can actually import CSV files and you can export this to a CSV file. So if you have a spreadsheet like this that you want to import and you have images with sold across them or whatever, and you don't even have to do that, but you can actually go back and recreate your sold listings or active listings or whatever you want to call this page and import them right here. So we're going to leave these in here for now. Let's see, let me go over here to Zillow.
I have a quick question regarding page. Okay, so the landing page that we added to our featured property page, this is a different tab, correct?
This is a dynamic page.
Okay. And what, so what
Joe has a new listing on 168 Pelican Loop. Nice. So I'm going to go over and grab that. And I'm going to change this name to Pelican Loop. And is 4/3/1927. I'm just going to make up some stuff in here. 4/3/1927, I think it said.
525.
525. Thank you. Oops. 168. And it's Pittsburgh, right?
Yeah.
For
that's
sale.
Already pending.
It's already pending?
Yes, in a day. Nuts. Better stay that way.
Mm-hmm. Boy, they're not staying on long. So I can, I'm going to take the description that I wrote for my MLS. You're not having to steal it off of Zillow, hopefully. Hopefully you have that saved somewhere on your, in your files. So, and now I can start adding my photos. And then once I have this done, I'm going to hit, let's see, sync items, continue syncing. And I'm going to get out of here. Now I'm going to go back to my home page. And we're going to add our page over here. So we're going to add dynamic pages, add to site. You don't have to do this part. I can do this part for you guys. So don't really worry about that. Says it's already added. Did we already add this on your site, Joe?
What, 168? Pelican? I don't think so. You have that Brocket one. I have to go back and mark that sold.
Oh, these are...
That's from Real Scout.
Yeah. There it is. Add to site. So now it's going to create our pages. And you can see it's going to create a single property page. And then it's going to create, hopefully, a collection. And we're going to have, let's see. Let's preview our collection. There we go. There's 168 Pelican Loop. And if we click on more, it's going to take us to the single property page, 168 Pelican Loop. And all of those fields that are in, all of those fields that are actually in your spreadsheet, we can now add into here. So I'm going to go back over here. And again, I don't expect you guys to do this. If this is something that you want added, I would be more than happy to add this for you. So now if we add a text box, for example, we're going to add, let's say, a heading, put it up here. And I'm going to connect it to the status. And I'm going to edit my text and change it to the right side. So now if I hit preview, see what it did? I connected it to that field in my spreadsheet. So for 168 Pelican Loop, it brought in the pending for one in one day, the status. So I can go in and develop this for you if you want to have this added. But again, it's called a dynamic page, and it's just like your blog page or your testimonial page. The newest always comes on first on top. So you can keep like a whole list of your properties here. And it's so it makes it really nice. If I go back to the preview page, let me go back to properties page. and preview that one. Again, we can add the status, we can add the price, anything you want in this text box right here, and it applies it to all of the rest of them. So I just wanted you to see that it's actually possible to do something like that right on your website so that you're not having to, it's okay to still have like the single property website from command added to that. And I think that's, I think it's really showing your seller that you're really marketing their listing. And I think that's probably more for the sellers than anybody else, right?
So on what page do they access this when they go into our front page? And then how do they get to this?
It depends. I mean, we can create, like Joe has a tab up here called listings. So if you okay. might have one called my listings or
recent. We have featured
properties. You have featured?
Yeah.
Okay. So everybody does it a little bit differently. And you just want, you know, we create a tab, we put it up here, and then they have an opportunity to come and look and see what you're currently listing or featuring. And then when they get so low, they're going to see that, wow, sold in 2 days, sold in 3 days. Wow, that's pending in 3 days. Wow. And so it's breaking rights, but it also, again, you can show your seller that I've got it here on my website. I've got the single property page on my website. So you can show them all the efforts that you're making in listing their property. So I'm going to close off with that. And if anyone needs help developing these pages out, let me know. Your guys' websites are looking good. And I have to say that several of you, and I see Bernadette's on here as well. She's been one that's gotten in and really learned a lot about her website, like Krista and Susie, and a lot of people have done that. Simon, I wish he were here. He's done a lot on his website. So is the Forecus team. So these are so easy to work in, and because they give you such a nice little spreadsheet to work with, it's easy to connect the data and to make the changes as you want. So if you have any questions about that, go ahead. I'm done. I'm going to stop talking. Everybody gets a chance to hit me hard here. Hello.
I was wondering, since we have you on the line here, if you could show us how to add information to our city pages.
Okay, anyone else have a question on this part before I jump on to something else?
That's a good one.
My last class, in fact, I have a video. If you don't have that video, it's actually on the Google Drive. I can give you access to it. But it shows you how to edit text and stuff on your website. So all you're going to do is we're going to go back to our editor here and get out of this part. I'll fix this, Joe. I'll remove this for you.
Okay.
We take it off right now, so. There we go. So we're going to go over here to your city page. We're not going to go to the menu. We don't want to edit the menu. We want to edit the page itself. Okay. So this is pages and this is menu. Some of you may have pages and menu all in one over here because that's the way it used to be. And if your site was went live before they made that change, they're slowly making this change on all websites, but yours may still be over here. So I'm going to go over here to Antioch, for example. And here's my text box. Let's say I want to change what it says about Antioch. So I click on this and say edit text. Does that answer your question?
Yeah, and what if you wanted to put like a restaurant or something in there? Can you add anything like that?
Well, what do you mean in a restaurant? You mean an image or a link or?
Yeah, I guess just like I wanted to like fill the city pages with interesting places, things to do.
Maybe something about the city center or something, you know, like
a. Well, I would probably make my map smaller, and then down here you're going to drag this, and you can say five things to do in Antioch, and you're just going to be adding text. You can add text, all kinds of headers, paragraphs, and then, or you can add an image. Again, I'm referring you back to what we did last time, and because that shows you how to put in images. So you're just going to add an image from your gallery here and upload it. If it's not here, you can just upload it from your hard drive, and you're just going to move it around and place it wherever you want to go. So that's easy to do, is to add that stuff. Now, what I will show you is that, let's say you want to add something about a restaurant. Some of the best SEO you guys can get on your websites, that's misspelled. Is, let's say I put in the name of a restaurant here. So I'm gonna highlight the name of the restaurant. I'm gonna go hit this link right here, and I'm gonna say web address, and I'm gonna put the URL to their restaurant right there. Or, and then I could put another one that goes to their menu or something. But those backlinks to external sites is like gold to Google. They love, 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 love that. So the more backlinks you have, the better off you are, the more SEO you can build. So I encourage everyone to go in and edit this and add things to do or other information about these different cities.
We could add the link to the school website as well.
Yeah, you can say Antioch Schools District, click link here. You can even just do it as a button by adding a button, just dragging a button down here and put Antioch Schools, click here. And same thing, you just add the link, external link for the web page and put it right there.
Patsy, how will we add a city or delete a city?
Well, deleting a city is easy. You just delete. You just go to the three dots and say delete.
Okay.
What I encourage you to do, if you're going to add a city, depending on where you want to go, where you want to put it. So let's say you want to put it between Oakland and Alameda. So I'm going to go over here to the three little dots, and I'm going to say duplicate. That way I keep the same format and okay, everything going. And so now I can call it Berkeley or whatever I want to put in there.
Okay.
And now I just go edit each of these text boxes.
Okay.
The one thing that I want to make sure that you know to do is that when you go here, you want to also go change the SEO, because you don't want it to say copy of Oakland. So you want it to have the put in, make sure that the SEO is right. You want this to say Berkeley.
Okay.
You want this to say Berkeley right here.
Okay.
So there's lots of little things that you have to do. And then when you get that done, don't worry, Joe, I'll fix it. Then you have to go up here to the mobile app and make sure that it sets right on your mobile app.
Okay.
This one I will show you real quick. I know we got to go. We've only got a couple minutes, so keep coming with the questions. This one I am experimenting with. I'm not ready to do this for people yet, but you can see I have neighborhoods in here. I think it looks pretty rough yet. I'm not real happy with the way it looks, but it's better than not having anything. Kind of. It's not an actual page. I'm sorry, it's a link. So I have to show you on the live site. So let's go to his live site. I keep forgetting what's links and what's not here. So under cities, you can see Antioch neighborhoods. I actually created this in Command. And it was extremely tricky to do. But once I kind of get this down a little bit better, I don't have a lot of control. And that's the thing with the command stuff, is that I don't have any control over how it looks. But this is what it is. So in Antioch, I was able to go in and actually select neighborhoods that I want on my neighborhood snapshot for Antioch. Now you'll see if I pick, let's pick Wild Horse, it brings in the listings in that neighborhood only. And I can go up here to, you can scroll down and see, then it's got a lead capture form. So it's pretty much just that. But you can also use this to send out to, you know, people that you want to show them what's available in a particular neighborhood. So up here, you notice it has home, and that's what we're on right now, or it has neighborhood stats. So if I click neighborhood stats, and let's go over here to Hillcrest Park, for example. So now you see Hillcrest Park, there's two homes for sale, one is pending. You've got the price, stay on market. You've got the current stats, you've got the sold stats. You also have transit and commutes, nearby schools. And then you have, oops, something went wrong. And then you have the homes that are for sale in Hillcrest and nearby neighborhoods. What's missing in here is actual, what's the other one, Joe? Is Hillcrest the one that you?
Wild Horse.
Wild Horse and?
Wild Horse, Hillcrest, and I think it's Montera. Or are you at, what was your question?
These actually pull from Kelly. So these neighborhood stats. So usually when I pull like Hillcrest, for example, all of the businesses within Hillcrest that somebody has done on their Kelly app as nearby our insights, what you call insights in Kelly, those show up in here. And it looks like that part is not working right now.
Oh, so keep doing our insights?
Yeah. See, because those usually show up in here.
Hey, I forgot all about it.
What's the place that is really close to downtown?
The place that's close to downtown Antioch?
Yeah.
Well, the River District? I never go, I don't really market over there, so downtown, no, those are all off of Lone Tree.
Yeah, none of it's working right now. I keep getting this. So, but you can kind of see the direction I'm trying to go with this. And again, I can't really change the way it looks, but if we can make it, if it's working, and usually it's working, I'm usually don't have a problem pulling these, search for a place. I don't know why this is not coming up. Interesting. So anyway, that's kind of the new, a new thing that I hope to have kind of coming out later on. You can see I did a couple of them for Joe. These are actually strangely created in your contacts. I have to set up a fake contact and apply all of those neighborhoods to that contact. So any questions on that, or how are we doing here? Because I don't want to go too long. I know we're over time here.
I'm good. Thank you.
Yeah, a lot of good information, Patsy.
Well, as long as these are worthwhile, I don't mind doing them. I'm going to continue to do them. And I just hope, you know, invite other people, even if they don't have one of my great new websites like y'all do. They'll just be jealous.
And is the last one you did, Patsy, it's on YouTube to review?
The last, which one? I'm sorry.
The last one that you did, the last class?
It was on MailChimp.
On MailChimp. Okay.
So let me see if it's working on this one. This one has a Silver Saddle has a lot of properties on it. catamaran circle. Let's go silver. What was I just on? Silver saddle right there. No, it's not working either. Okay, I give up on that one. Thank you, Joe, for letting us demonstrate. I think I got you all cleaned up now. You shouldn't have any problems on your website.
Thanks, Patsy. Thanks for putting that spelling error on San Francisco. Boy, was that bothering me.
I know, I could tell. You were biting your nails. It's funny because all of a sudden I'll have someone call and say that there was a typo somewhere, and I'm like, you've had your website for 3 months. You're just now telling me? But a lot of people already know how to go in and just edit and correct those little things that they see. And honestly, when I get so close to this, you can't proofread yourself, right? So I really depend on you guys to tell me those things, and I love to correct them. And because I like to take care of you guys to make sure it's all good. So we're going to go back here, and anything else? Anything anyone else has to say? I know I'm 2 minutes over, so I'm going to stop my share because it's going to be way too long to send out.